you should be relaxed. And I will show you some pictures of my home, yes? Where I live, yes? And how we celebrate the winter. I live not in Austria, probably you can hear it from the accent, I think that that's quite clear. It's the same accent like Arnold Schwarzenegger. That's a beautiful view of the wine cellars. And here you see the view again, yes. I'm not in the part of Austria where you have the hills. I'm in the part where it's quite flat. It's softy, yes, you can see it here. The wine will produce. We'll see also the landscape. And in the winter, we're more hidden in the cellars by itself. Yes, you will see it here. And then you will got something what we got yesterday. It's called Bratäpfel, yeah? That's also a Christmas market. It's not a huge one. It's in the middle of nowhere, yes? Where you have some heating devices, yes? Some kids are singing, yes? And then probably, it's a big surprise, probably Santa Claus is coming, yes? That in Austria we say the Christkind, yes? We don't have a Weihnachtsmann, we have a Christkind, yes? And you will see probably this guy on the saxophone playing, yes? On a hidden place, yes? And also slow down. And that brings me to the first point. As Bernard pointed out, long time, it was 2010, we developed a software, it's called Phosphor-S, it's now standard of localization. It's one of the three top journals in Journal of Proteome Research. If you look at Wikipedia, you will see two journals of Matthias and the Phosphor-S paper. And also at the same time, we invested in something, it's called quality control. For scientists, how can I say quality control? That's a shoe which did not really fit, yes? We have to do quality control. I don't like to do it, but it was necessary. And therefore, we developed a quality control tool. It's called Sympatico. And it's still alive, yes? And the question is also, can this old dog, and probably Bernard is also one of the old dogs, yes, in the front, learn new tricks, yes? And I can give you some input in Sympatico. We have here a raw boot. That means all the files, quality control files, what we produce on the QExactive and the Lumos are automatically uploaded to the Sympatico server. The Sympatico server starts with his own programs, own methods. We have no influence. We will start the database search in Mascot behind, yes. We will read out some parameters from the mass spec, as example, the injection time in MS1, MS2, how often do we find the log mass, in this case 96%, or also the average deviation of the mass accuracy, in this case we have 2.5 ppm. We see here some chromatography features. We measured the peak half-width, yes, of the chromatography. And with the peak half-width, we can also check how good the chromatography is. We can measure the area of the peptides, the average intensity, the score, and the retention time, yes? And in this case, you will see here, that's a good chromatography system. We got the peak half-width of 6.3 seconds, which is really excellent for a system with a pre-column. And later on, the column got a little bit dirty, and the peak half-width goes down to approximately 12 seconds. We can measure the spray, yes? That's a feature. It's called MS rho over FT, where we measure directly the ions in the orbit trap. And what you can see here, the spray looks quite beautiful. And if the spray got a little bit more lousy, then we got the spikes, yes? And it means the number of ions in the orbit trap is not well calculated, and therefore the spikes are there. And the question is, can we really learn new tricks? And probably, as you know, that's one of the new fancy instruments of Thermo. That's the HFX. And the question is, how good is the performance of the system over a long time period, and how often do you have to clean the systems? And are there any times of measurement values where you can say, no, I stop, and now we will clean the system, yes? And there are some videos on YouTube available how you can clean the systems. You can do it by yourself. If you do it by yourself, probably use the warranty or you need a service contract. And we have done an experiment that's called simplified isolation switch. We isolate on a 25 nanogram Heller cell, I said, which is more the lower amounts, the peptides with 0.1 or 0.4 Dalton. And what you can see here, you see all the parameters. You see here the MASCOT results. With MASCOT, we got 4,600 PSMs. And if the instrument is not in a good shape, with 0.4 Dalton, it's the same run, we got nothing. I think the answer is quite clear. With one Dalton isolation with 4,500 PSMs, with 0.4 Dalton, nothing. Yes? That means the instrument has to be cleaned. And how does it look like on a good system? You can see it here. We got with one isolation with 5,200 in this case, with 0.7, 5,200, and with 0.4, 5,000 PSMs. It means if you get similar numbers with a narrow isolation width, the instrument, the quad isolation, is in a perfect shape. That means that's a good measurement value, how good the system works. And that's new. Also, the old dog can learn new tricks. And we have the advantage that we can program all the things in our software. And also in the next version, we will have one run with three different isolation widths. That means the variance is quite low. And we extract these different isolation widths. We do with the isolation width independent database search. And then you can see here the difference how the system performs. That's our trick, how we can monitor the performance of a QExactive or Lumos system. There was a cross-linking presentation of Richard, and also I will follow up a little bit the cross-linking talk. There are two major cross-linking reagents, cleavable cross-linking reagents available. Both are in the catalog of peers, you can buy this. And I will put up a slide from Ben. You know Ben quite well, yes? The question was, do we need really ion traps for MS3 and ETD for cross-linking search? Or can we do cross-linking search on a QExactive? Not everybody in the lab has one of these fancy Lumos machines. If you have not the budget, then, of course, you need a QExactive to run your cross-linking experiments, yes? And the outcome of Ben with this paper in the hand, which was published or pre-published in BioArchive, now we have a reason to head to the lab on Cross Sunday morning and see if I can get some of these samples to give up the cross-linking we know are in the somewhere, yeah? That means he's really running to the lab and start his experiments. And in the following slide, I will show how it works up. That's a normal cross-linking workflow. It was published by Huang, or also by Richard Scheltemer. You have here a CID spectra. From the CID, you do the MS2 CID. You will get those pairs, these two peptide pairs, and you will do your MS2 spectra, or MS3 spectra of these four peptide pairs. The disadvantage, also Richard pointed out, MS3 is not as sensitive as MS2. That's not a big surprise, we know it. And if the sample is complex, you lose the time on the mass spec. The other possibility to work with ETD, but the fragmentation behavior of ETD is not as good as this MS3 method. And therefore, we come up with the idea to work with normalized collision energy to test different types of collision energy in the HCD. We have seen some similar from Petro for the spectrum libraries, where you have different collision energies. But in any case, you have to take care at first. Do you work on a Lumos instrument or QXactive instruments? Both produce have not the same values. And also, the instruments are a little bit different from instrument to instrument. It's also that dependent on the settings, what you have, as example, on the HCD cell. And if we work with different collision energies, and you will see here the bottom mark of CID, we got for the signature ions, yes, the best result with approximately 21, 24. If we look at the spectrum quality, we got best results with a collision energy of nearby 27, 30 to have the highest sequence coverage of the peptides. That means, what should we do? Should we work with 24 or 30? And you can see this here in the graph the same again. And you see this on a RAW file. I think it's our MSMS spectra. We have here the peptide pairs. With a collision energy of 21, you will produce nice peptide pairs. With higher collision energy, you also get the charge shift of one of the peptide pairs, and it's nearby the noise. And with 33, you will see a nice ion series, as you can see at the collision energy of 21. And the idea what we have, we combine the beauty of both. And the beauty of both, it's called step collision energy. You can do step collision energy easily on the QXactive on the Lumos. And we tested three different step collision energies. It's 27 plus minus 6, 27 plus minus 3, and 24 plus minus 3. And we got the most cross-linking peptides with a combination of 27 plus minus 6. To have further improvement of our method, we compared the step collision energy, the green one, with the MS2, MS3 method, which is the favorite method at the moment for Thermo, for Rosa Weiner, and the CIT-EDD method in yellow. And you will see in this case on an albumin, which is only one protein, both methods are quite similar. If we go to a complex with 100 protein subunits, as example the ribosome complex, we will get 40% more crosslinks with the step collision energy compared to the MS3 method. And we follow up a paper of Yuri Rapsilber. Yuri work on a sequential digest protocol. That means he digested with trypsin and afterwards with another enzyme. And that this is an example of GluC. And what you can see here, in comparison to the MS3 method, we got also 45% more cross-linking peptides. In the ribosome complex, we got approximately 800 crosslinks. It's a huge amount. And for this 800, it's a very stringent settings. We work with 1% FDR, but we are not so happy with 1% FDR with X-Link-X. And we work with additional settings with a minimal score and also with a delta CN score, yes, which filter out the false positives. And in this case, I think 200 or 300 PSMs are kicked out We're not interested to get the highest number. We're really interested to be on the safe side. That means the lower HED collision energy preserves the formation of the reporter doublets. The higher collision energy increases the sequence coverage. And the step collision energy allows to combine the beauty of both methods. That means we have now really now a good method available for the Q-executive where you can measure your cross-linking results and you can read these results at the BI archive. Further on, would like to a little bit talk about Protein Discoverer, the nodes. The beauty of Protein Discoverer is it works like apps. You can add these apps. And it's a really a beautiful framework to work with it. And if you work with our nodes, you can work with Protein Discoverer free of charge. As also Bernard pointed out, you install the demo license. The demo license runs out. And with all our nodes, MSMunda and so on, you can work with Protein Discoverer free of charge. You will find all nodes at ptnodes.org. And you will see here a huge amount of different nodes. And also, you will see here the different versions what we have, yes? We have here, as example, PhosphorS, we have IMP Quant, we have MSMunda, SHA-MIT, SugarCube. It's a special software where you can detect complex patterns of sugar sites. We have MSANA. MSANA is a spectrum library search engine. We have Hyperplex. Hyperplex is for TMT spectra. With Hyperplex, you can also measure the CTMT. It's a paper published by the Gigi Lab. We have a normalization load, LIMA, spectrum processor. Some nodes are not anymore necessary. We don't need recalibration. And we have here a new software page. It's called MS2Go. Yes, but we don't have it here on the homepage, yes, because it's included in the third package, okay. Yes. Okay. Yeah, it's now a full part of Protein Discoverer, and not the additional load, as you know, yeah.
Nope,
and therefore, okay,
you're right.
Yeah.
You're right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Some facts also for programmers. There's no standard about the framework in the background. That means for each of the nodes, we have to adapt it for the dedicated Protein Discoverer version, which is really a disadvantage because for some projects, the programmers are gone, it was a masterwork, and then we don't have really sometimes the power with the follow-up. As a consequence, as I pointed out, the versions are not compatible. And it's difficult also for programmers. And the future will be really good if there's a standardized framework in the background, like what they expect of an industry software. One of the popular softwares what we have now, it's MS2Go. MS2Go is a translation tool for biologists. As you know, in the mass spec world, you have your own language. Own language, it's called M over SIT, charge date, PSM. Some biologists have difficulties with the term post-transcendental modifications, PTM, yes. And you need something where you do a translation. And with MS2Go, we can directly read the result from the Protein Discoverer file. It's not necessary to export the CSV file. And you can see all the necessary information in one wonderful Excel sheet, where you have the contaminants here, the accession number, the description, the area, the label-free area, the molecular function, molecular weight, and so on. You can go here to the peptide details. You will see the different kind of modifications. It's the same peptide. It's non-modified. And you will see here, as example, the histones quite easily. Okay, this peptide is only this modification. Is here, it's without modification, and the sample we see only the modified peptides in different flavors, yes? We see here as example of a TMT experiment. Also, MS2Go now supports TMT, and what you easily see here, red and blue colors, and it's the lock. And if it's downregulated, it's a minus. Upregulated, it's a plus. And the blue and the yellow makes the difference. And you can easily sort it to up or downregulated proteins. We have quality control there. It means number of PSMs in a dedicated experiment, retention time and PSMs, the ID speed. In this case, we have the number of PSMs, and the control shows much less PSMs as the samples, which is sometimes the case. And if you would like to publish your results, you will see here all the information in the MS2Go. Send the information to the biologist, and they can publish your results. And at the moment, we got more than 500 downloads of MS2Go. It's not as bad. Another tool what we developed and still published, it's EpiQuant. The advantage of EpiQuant, it's a label-free quantification. You can calculate your false discovery rate in terms of quantification. In the moment, you don't know the false discovery rate in identification, but you have no idea how good or how bad your label-free quantification is. And that's the only software so far where you can do this calculation. In this case, you will see a comparison with MaxQuant. It's a published data set. You will see here in this plot some important proteins of the complex are inside. And we found these proteins here quite nicely separated in a combination with LEMA. LEMA, it's a statistic tool which comes from the microarray technique. And sometimes you have here the biologist. And the question what we always got, can you find out new modifications in my sample? That's a quite common question. They got a list of 2,000 proteins. They're interested in new modifications, yes? And the question is, how can we handle this in a routine way? How can we handle this in a core facility? And what's our tips and tricks to find new modification? You can do this, or you can search in the data, or you can work with dedicated software. And for this, we have two possibilities. The first possibility is a blind PTM search. That's a approach was a long time ago published by David Tapp. And you will find here a lot of different modifications. You will get the overview. But indeed, the software is not perfect. It's not designed for high-resolution MSMS data. In this case, we found also some 4- and 6-plex experiment, 4- and 6-plex data, and the data are still not there, yes? It means it's a little bit error one, but you will find modifications and you will get a nice overview in quite fast time. The software is available for Protein Discover 2.1. The other method is, as example, to do a research of the data. It means you have here your common workflow. You will get a list of 2,000, 3,000 proteins of an IP. And what we do, we save the proteins in a database. We put the database then in MSMANDA again, and we do a research of the data with up to 30 modifications. To check how the research works, we have a feature, it's called SearchBase. It means, SearchBase means you have one single spectra, and what's the amount of candidates in the database what you're searching again, yes? It means if you have a large database, the search base will be higher. If you have a small database, the search base is quite small. It's also dependent on the mass accuracy of the machine. If you have 5 ppm, it's small. If you have 100 ppm, it's high. And with the search base, we have also a control for the PTM search. And what we expect that we have approximately similar numbers for the second PTM search as for the first search to have also a good evidence. And in the moment, we are really able to measure then more than 30 modifications. You can do this in a Mesomander. You will see here the list. You have a list of 20. If you have phosphorylation, you can, as example, work with serine, threonine, and tyrosine. And in this case, we got the add-on of 20% more PSMs, which are only additional modifications we found. And for all our samples, what we do in the service facility, they searched against minimum 20 modifications. That means the biologist has the sample in the hand and say, yes, this protein is phosphorylated, this protein is acetylated, we have here a novel N-acetylation site, yes, we have here an upregulation. This could be of interest for our approach. And if it is down or upregulated, it will give additional information. That means you know we are now in the dark area of the proteome and the information is there, but we have to look for it. I gave a similar presentation last year and asked the colleagues of Thermo to develop some software. We got nothing, yes, that was the outcome. And therefore, we developed our own workflow now, yes. You will see here, we have the spectrum files, the spectrum selector, we have the pre-calculator, we do here the database search, and we have here a new node, it's protein research. It means we save the proteins with a confidence of 1% FDR in the database, and we put the database in MSMander and do a research with the 20 or 30 modifications. Now we can do this in one step. And this means with this approach, you are able really to find 20, 30 modifications in your sample. The information is there. It's free of charge. You only have to press the start button, and then you will get the result. That's it. And that's a modern concept in proteome research, that you not have only one search. You have a combination of different tools, of different workflows. And bring me to the second point that was also mentioned by Ben Osborne in one of his blogs, yes. What you can do here, it's the other type of modern concept. You will see here the spectrum recalibration node, the spectrum selector. You will see here MSANA. MSANA is our spectrum library tool. And with MSANA, as example, you can got out the first 300,000 PSMs. And with the rest, you do a database search. You can do this with a lot of different PSMs. You will get additional information. And with the rest, you can do, as example, de novo sequencing. That's a quite modern workflow in proteome research. It means it's a combination, a quite new combination, from spectrum libraries to database search with a lot of modifications and a de novo sequencing at the end, yes? With the less candidates which are available, yes? The disadvantage of the method, at the moment it did not work. it's a dream, yes, we can do this and this. The Nova node, it's quite new, we got it 2 weeks ago. It's from a company which is based in Canada. The people worked before for the company, it's called Beaks, and now they have their own company. We got good candidates with the Nova node. But we have to more integrate the results in the protein discovery result. That means that, as example, if you see a splice variant, it's also in the result there. And for this, you need a lot of power to do this, yes? Yeah?
Does it need a license, the Novo node?
No, it's free. Everything free, yes? What do you think? No, don't need a license, yes? And you will see here the workflow again in big pictures. That brings me to the end of my presentation. Single-cell proteomics is one of the future topics in proteomics. It's also a little bit more a dream. Nearby, nobody can work with single cells. Believe me, the material is quite low. There are some papers published from the community in Boston about single-cell proteomics. I think you know this.
Is that true?
Pardon?
Is that true?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's published.
Yeah.
If I say it, it's so, yeah? I think there's no point, yes? No, the manuscript was a long time on the road, I think 1 year, yeah? And now it's published. It's a proof of concept paper. It's not a perfect manuscript. They still work with TMT as carrier proteins and can measure 300 cells. And then they quantify the proteins from the 300 cell towns to the one cell, yes? The problem is a little bit more, how can I say, the background of TMT and all the things, yes? Because you have ion suppression in TMT experiments in this. But it's a proof of concept paper. I also invited the people in Boston, and I invite you to Vienna. The conference is done with a colleague, with Roman Zubarev together. And we will see what's going on, yes? And at the end of the day, I will thank my programmers. I have three programmers in my group. It's Andrea Lüttig, Florian Stanek, and the head is Gerhard Dürnberger. And the cross-linking experiments was done by Christian Stieger. Would like to thank Victoria Doffer for the nice cooperation. Victoria did the development of MS Amanda and also MS Anna and all the software which is developed in der Hagenberg. It starts with an A and it's the name of a woman, yes? That's the rules what we have. And also like to thank the RapidNova team for the nice cooperation and you for your attention. And I'm happy to answer any kind of your questions, yes?